first let's take a look with no explanation.
Joe Vendice utilizza l'Alcom Electronics di cui è presidente per vendere droga? Look, mi dica perché dovremmo crederle.
Vendice was a friend of my husband. They were students. He was just like all of them. But then he started to get the drugs and sell them to other people.
And then he had a business and now he's got this industry.
Ne ha fatto un business. Ora ha un'industria.
Still gave my husband a discount.
Ma mio marito aveva lo sconto.
Whatever. He even gives the kids in my school a discount.
I ragazzi a scuola hanno lo sconto.
And he probably gives the carabinieri a discount.
Dice che anche i carabinieri hanno lo sconto.
Ma che sta dicendo?
I have taught 13-year-old children who have already been in rehab.
Ho insegnato a ragazzini di 13 anni che sono già stati in cure.
This is what I have been writing and writing and writing and writing to you about. Forget the business, the computers, it's just a
front. Noi abbiamo eseguito un controllo, a noi non risulta nessuna lettera, nessuna deposizione, nessuna telefonata, a noi non risulta niente.
I have copies of those.
Whether it's intentional or by chance, we don't know, but we can clearly see the loaded garbage truck passing by. Two key elements have been said with this. One is for the sake of the story, and the other is just an allegoric kind of conclusion. First says it's early in the morning. We can also see that by the position of the sun. And the second one is a likening between the load of garbage and whom Flipper and the Carabinieri is talking about. After seeing this classic establishing shot, we cut to the inside. It's genius, we hear the main character's voice but instead see others' reaction to it. Different persons with different point of views. There's no need to see all of them because they have their own act later in the scene. All of the previous shots are static, with no motion, but at the point we cut to Flipper and the picture and the monologue become synchronized, the camera starts to move. The camera slightly tracks on Flipper, from left to right, and the direction changes when we cut to the opposite angle. The camera movement starts exactly when the story gets more spice. This is one of the best examples of what an actress or actor do to impress the dramatic quality of the written text. Just by taking a look at how Cate Blanchett says three similar sentences with three different tunes.
Still gave my husband a discount.
A mio marito aveva lo sconto.
Whatever. He even gives the kids in my school a discount.
I ragazzi a scuola hanno lo sconto.
And he probably gives the carabinieri a discount.
The first one is a report with a sudden shred of grief because she's talking about her husband with whom she has no more sympathy. In the second one, she says it with a heart full of sorrow and regret because she's talking about her students. And for the third one, she says it with suspicion and a little bit of anger because it reveals an organized corruption. She scratches and turns her head while saying it as a sign not to say it directly. After this, we see Flipper's reaction. He pauses for a second because he knows what that means. Then he translates it and we see the other's reaction to that. Conversation scenes are one of the most important and frequent parts of the movies, and they are the trickiest also because at first they look so simple, but when we look closer, we see how great directors manage to pull them off with the juxtaposition of close-ups, two shots, over the shoulders and so on. Take for instance Sidney Lumet's 12 Angry Men, which is full of these intense moments all in one small room. When Flipper starts to talk about children in her school, the camera zooms in on Flipper. We all know that it's a form of drawing attention to a subject, so by that we understand that Flipper is getting involved too, plus the fact that they are talking at the same time, both in English and Italian, as they are on the same side. Then again a tracking shot, and the way Cate Blanchett acts and helplessly begs them to understand her. The white shirt in this film plays a significant role. It's not random because it's a motive that continues throughout the entire movie. She's the convict, but the only one who is wearing an innocent color. These series of shots are antonyms. Hope, then cut to an executive factor, then again despair, because the camera is still in motion, but she's steady and motionless. Then Flipper's a waiting eye, with an over-the-shoulder shot where we can see Flipper's face out of focus, which leads to a marvelous yet hidden match cut. She sits back, we start with her out-of-focus movement, and we cut to her, in focus, sitting back, continued from the last scene. And for God's sake, just take a look at how she plays with her eyes, full of tears, and resisted not to burst that crying.
And that's it.